Jun. We're gonna go ahead and feature your car. Let's pop the hood on this thing. Let's see what engine you're running. Wait, does it open that way?
It opens, yeah.
Oh, okay, nice. Oh, sick. What kind of engine is that?
So that's a KA motor. It's the same motor that Kenji built for the Wagon.
Wow. Yeah. This is such a flex. Like, this is, well, this is this.
Yeah.
You want to talk about a flex? You have your own model of your car, like, perfect. What a cool, I mean, yeah. Of course, this is a little wilder.
Right.
Right? This is just maybe something in another dimension, or
yep.
Maybe if you took your Wagon even crazier, not to say your Wagon isn't crazy, your Wagon is insane. So I've been chasing you for so long to feature this vehicle.
Yeah.
Because I've been watching you build this from afar.
Right.
And it just gets crazier and crazier. It's just so cool that it's finally in a good place now. It's done, it drives. We just did some rolling shots now. So what was the story behind this? I think I saw this in your garage the first time I went to your house.
Right.
The corner.
Yeah, and you came to shoot, what, the Z?
Yes. Right?
So you came to shoot the blue Z. This was off in the corner. That was a good 10, no, more than, it had to be more than 10 years ago.
It's been a while.
It's been a long time.
Yeah.
Well,
so then what's the story with this? Was it this color? Where did you get it? What's the story with this?
So I bought this in, I want to say 2007 or 2008. I bought this from a gentleman in Santa Barbara. And he was the original owner of it. You know, kind of an older guy. Just lost interest in it, couldn't drive it anymore, put it up for sale. I don't recall the price of it, but it was ridiculous. I mean, they were so cheap back then, right? But the exterior had all these like interesting dings, right? Like they're like vertical dings all around the car. And I was like, what's up with that? Like, where are the dings from? He was a surfer and he showed me all these pictures of like him surfing. So it was like surfboard leaning on the car, just kept dinging it over all those years. But the interior was super clean in the car. And for me, it's like interior, like once an interior is kind of scrapped out, like it's a little hard to bring it back to life. So I was like, you know what? Clean interior.
Yeah.
Sold. So I bought it. The car otherwise was fairly stock. This wasn't the original color, but it was an olive green that was close to it. It was a little bit darker. And that's where the build started. 2007, 2008.
I can see the original color on the floor. It's not
on
that
floor?
Different.
Right.
It is pretty similar. It's like a similar shade of green.
Yeah. I think actually in the back, the hatch or the inside is the original green. You can see it's a lot darker.
Oh. How does this open? Right here?
Yeah. Just push it and pop it.
This has so much room.
I think, this is actually the original color here.
Oh, it's not that bad.
No.
It's actually pretty close. It's just a little bit darker shade.
Yeah.
So then, when did you start on this build?
I started on it right away. So, a friend of mine who was really into Datsun, so this was kind of like my first Datsun, right? So, I didn't have a lot of experience with it, didn't really know what I was doing. But we, you know, did the ghetto lowering job. We cut the coils and brought it down and just kind of got it up and running really good. And since then, it just snowballed. And over the course of, I would say, the first 2 or 3 years, just really got into it. It just started getting lower and lower and lower. And we started doing, you know, I was running the L16, ran that for a long time. And just, you know, putting twin SUs and just kind of the basic Datsun things and just making it a fun, reliable runner.
Huh.
And yeah, just kind of kept going with that. And then I would say a year after ownership, I decided, you know, I want a clean body. So I did the body work myself.
Oh, really?
Painted this car in my garage.
It looks really, really good.
Yeah, I mean, for, you know, from a distance, it looks fine. If you get up close, it's, you know, you can see the flaws, but that's okay for a
What car. Color is this?
This is called like an olive gray green. I don't have the paint code, but it is a Datsun color. I don't know if it's a 510 color. Should be. Yeah, I love this color. I think it's this color kind of, it makes the wagon, like it just pulls it all together. And a lot of people, when they see this color, they just identify with this wagon, this particular wagon. So it's
so cool. So yeah. Then this oil cooler setup, this is kind of like the Kaido racer inspired.
Yeah,
setup.
Totally. Yeah, it's all right? It's all inspired by the Kaido street racer style. This is actually plumb too. It's all hooked up.
So it's functional.
It's
not just for looks.
No, it is not for looks. It's 100%
so
functional.
So for those of people who don't know, the Kaido racers are highway racers inspired from actual super silhouette cars from the 70s and 80s in Japan.
Right.
And then so these individuals build these cars so wild, so crazy, and they race them on the highway. Now that it's more for show.
Yeah.
But this is just like a little bit of taste of inspiration from that.
Yeah.
So then what else did you do to the exterior? You have over fenders. What kind of lip is that?
That's a BRE style lip. Actually, this was given to me from a friend, so I don't know the exact origins of it, but I mean, this car, it goes together really well, but it's got quite a bit of work. So just the body itself. So these are over fenders from Refresh 60 in Yokohama. So I got these from Obata-san. Actually, these mirrors are also from Obata-san's personal car. So they're actually really special pieces just in the mirrors alone. This part, so his flares are actually compatible with a two-door and a four-door 510. Not 100% compatible with a wagon because a wagon is a little different. Even though it's kind of like a four-door, the body's still a little different. So we did a lot of massaging to make that work.
It's not bad.
Yeah.
It fits pretty well. It's kind of cool. It reveals the AO52 Yokohama tire there pretty well. Tell me about the wheels. What an aggressive
setup.
So the
wheels are work equipped 40s, 15x9, negative 40 offset. And my man JC over at Work Wheels in Japan got those built up for me. And they fit the car not only because of the over fenders, but because this wagon has IRS in the back.
Mm.
So the wagons have, they come stock with a straight axle. So we actually cut the whole floor out of this wagon and installed a sedan floor. So it's got all the suspension points, IRS.
That's something that I wouldn't have thought about because I noticed that it does have a lot more camber in the rear.
Oh yeah. Yeah, when you see a wagon, they never have camber because they're on a straight axle.
That's why.
But this, when you slam it, it pulls the wheels in so we can get a wider tire, wider wheel back there.
It looks really, really good. Yeah. So then tell me a little bit about the interior, and then what I'll do is I'll talk to Kenji about the engine because I know he's the one who built the engine.
Yeah.
And that's kind of like the highlight. That's the feature of this vehicle.
Yeah.
So then tell me about the interior.
So the interior, we have speed hub gauges because we have a whole new engine in there. We needed to get a new gauge system. So they actually made some custom Kaidohouse face gauges, which are really cool.
They're really nice.
Yeah, they're nice. The interior for the most part is stock. So stock dash. The dash pad is from the guys from Datsun Garage. So I want to give a shout out to them because they provided the dash pad, all the new seals for the windows, and they make a lot of great stuff. Some of the stuff is still obviously a little unfinished over there, but we're getting it. One of my favorite parts of this is actually the driver's seat. And people always ask about why it says Fuguzi. So this seat was actually the driver's seat, the original driver's seat out of Fuguzi. It's a gift from Sung. So much love to Sung for this. And
I've sat in that seat before.
Yeah. Right.
I've driven the Fuguzi.
Yeah. So
I've sat in that seat before.
So
that's so funny.
We've shared the same space here, just in different cars.
That is so neat.
Yeah.
Before we talk to Kenji, I just wanted to talk a little bit about Kaidohouse Garage and what you're doing with these awesome mini GTs. First of all, I'm excited because I have my own that's coming out. This is something that I'm really excited about. You're making a lot of cars that are, I wouldn't say iconic, but they're in your friend group.
Right.
But you're making like a extreme version of them, just like you did with this 510.
Yeah.
And then this one is of my 240Z, and it really is the extreme version of it. But my favorite part is the packaging.
Yeah.
So I did have a chance to preview this very quickly at Tokyo Auto Salon, but I just want to show you guys on camera for the first time, just all the little details about it. What's cool is there's a whole story just in pictures. That's like 21, 22 year old me with my car. It still had the louvers, the wheels that came with it. That's me in a motorcycle helmet, autocrossing.
I never noticed
that. You know, that's the first day I ever drove the car on PCH with stock hood and everything. It's all rusty, stock engine. To me, this is so important because it's so cool that it tells a story of the car through time. And then you see other bits of it, like me looking through the headlights, you know, as we were restoring it. That's me photographing my own car.
That's a great shot.
And then the last, that's with the SR. So that's the most recent engine. And then this is the last shot that we took of it. This is just such a cool piece. It's not just about the model. While the model is really cool and it's so detailed, and you can open up the hood, the interior, all of it is so detailed, and you can even see me on there, my sticker on the back, and then of course my partner's, you know, Type S. It's just so, I can't believe how detailed this is. It's just really an honor. Oh, and Advan, look, I can't believe, I don't know if you guys are able to pick this up on video. If you guys are watching this in 4K, you can definitely see that it clearly says Yokohama Advan, which is what I run. I'm running AO55s on that car now, which is so insane. This is just so cool. I mean, talk about a flex. So cool. So tell me, what are you actually doing with Kaidohouse Garage and Mini GT?
So this is an interesting collaboration. So this is actually, this is a product collaboration with Mini GT, which is a maker of diecast models. And we're going into our third year now. And when we first kicked off the collaboration, we discussed about what these products are going to be about and how they're going to differ from other models in this category. And for me, we call this Kaido GT, so it's Kaidohouse Mini GT. This is essentially like, you know, tuning in 1/64th in another dimension, right? It's almost like if you could take it to the extreme, to the next level, which may be very difficult or hard to do in real life, it's like, well, in diecast, we could essentially do anything we want.
Yeah.
Right? So really wanted to capture all the things that are important in diecast, the details, the innovations, the realism, but also just like for me, when I do a diecast model, I want it to feel more like the sketch or like what you think about in the imagination versus trying to make it like absolutely true scale and realistic to the real world. And for me, I think that's where the magic is, and that's why the Kaido GT product looks very different compared to other diecasts in the market, is because it has the artistic expression versus, you know, trying to make it exact replica of a car.
Yeah, I really like that. And then I also like how detailed, I just can't get over how detailed it is. The carbon fiber is really nice. The little side mirrors, the interior, like I said, all of the decals. And then the engine bay is, how do you open this one?
So this one's a little tricky. So because it's a forward tilt, it doesn't really open, and because we have such precision tolerances, you actually need a pin to open it. But what we did was we opened up the chassis. So this actually serves two purposes. One, so you can see the details, right? Mm-hmm. But also so you can put a pin in there and open the hood. Oh, let's see. GTR key.
GTR key works.
GTR key works.
Okay, that's good to know.
All right.
So GTR key opens it up.
Yeah.
But you want to talk about detail. Oh. So this is really cool because this shows my car if it was in another dimension and I went crazy and I kept the L series motor. And look at that, the valve cover says Kaidohouse, very detailed, all the ITBs. We're such nerds.
I know.
We're the worst. So then
right.
How many have you made so far over these 3 years?
I think we are at product number, we just crossed 120. So we've got quite a few releases.
Does anybody have the entire collection?
Yeah, a lot of people do. A lot of people do. And some of these cars are really hard to get, right? Because what we see here, these are your normal retail models. So you can pre-order them from Mini GT dealer, or you could just buy them after they ship from most retailers, even like Amazon, right? You can find them on Amazon. But we have some exclusive models that are exclusive to our website, or they're exclusive to an event, and they may be a super short run, like a few hundred cars, and they usually sell out instantly. Mm. But there are people, if they don't get it, then they'll just track it down, they'll trade, they'll do whatever they're gonna do.
Ugh.
Yeah, it's hard. It gets really hard to get them all, but I mean, we have a really growing and dedicated community and fan base, and they're like, they gotta have them all.
You know? I love it, I love it. I can't believe it. Look how close, it pretty much disappears. Like, look at this part. Look at that, look. On the video,
yeah.
It disappears because of how close the color matches. And this is gonna disappear too. If I put it next to my actual car, the color is gonna match so well. And that's what I just love about it. It's just all the little details.
Yeah.
So let's go ahead. I'm gonna talk to Kenji. Kenji's right there. We're gonna talk to Kenji about the motor.
Yes.
And then that way we can finish this feature. Things I love about anti-gravity batteries. Lighter weight. Restart feature with remote key fob. Doesn't leak. No corrosion on the terminals. Longer life. Faster, more efficient charging. More output. Get yours at antigravitybatteries.com. All right, Kenji.
All right,
You're a regular on our channel.
It is. Huh?
I'm so lucky to be able to feature a lot of the cars that you have your hands on.
Mm.
This is so cool. So this is, the KA motor is what came in a couple cars in the US.
240SX.
In the Nissan market, right?
Right.
Mainly 240SX.
Everybody calls it the truck motor, but I forgot what it was. It was in one of those Nissan.
Well, it was in an Altima here too.
Altima, yep.
Yeah, so then
it was a front wheel drive setup.
Yep.
Yeah.
This is a 2.4 liter inline four.
Yeah.
And what's the reason why this is in here versus like a SR or L series?
When June, you know, started talking about, you know, he told you about the whole history of this car, right? And he got it T-boned and all that, and he got it repaired, and he was at the shop for a while, and he wanted to rebuild it. And when we started talking about, you know, engine package, and, you know, 510, I think SR20 is pretty popular, either that or keeping the original engine and kind of restoring it. But, you know, there's a, you know, I'm sure there's going to be a lot of people commenting on this, but there's always been a SR versus KA, you know, debate of which four-cylinder engine is better. I'm a KA guy.
Really?
I had a 240SX I built when I bought my 95 240, brand new, back in 96. And I built that right when I started working here. I started building that, and I made, 750 horsepower out of a KA.
Wow.
But,
but this was never meant to be a forced induction engine, though.
No. So it was NA, but I think the head design, the way... And I prefer the KA head design more than the SR with the rocker arm and all that. You could make these things pretty bulletproof. This is fully built as well. I worked with OCD Works. Scott Wolf also had a 1,000 horsepower KA back in the day with twin turbo setup. So we're both like a KA fan. So when, you know, June came up to me about this project, I was like, KA all the way. Please don't say SR20. And he's like, whatever you want to do. And we had a exhaust manifold, cast manifold from our 240 kit back in the day.
Uh-huh.
We had a bolt-on kit for the 240, and I still had the manifold, so it kind of made it easy to kind of make this package together.
So you guys don't have these anymore?
We don't sell it as a kit anymore,
uh-huh.
But I have a couple of these cast manifold left still. So
that is so neat.
Yeah.
It looks really, really good. It almost looks OE. Huh. So yeah. Then that paired up with...
our TD06 20G RX. So Trust gave me a new turbo. It's a billet wheel and all that. So it's more current setup that Trust have, but To make things simple, we just made an actuator type, but after dynoing this, I think we need to go with a maybe a little bit bigger setup. I think he liked the response and everything, but I think we might do a little bit of update. And we have a different cast manifold. We also sell Artec performance manifolds here at GReddy now. And they make a nice V-band KA manifold. So we have it in stock, so we might put that and use our new GReddy turbo setup. So we might update this a little bit.
That's just so cool that even though it's such an old motor, there's still so many things available for this.
Yeah. I mean, these are pretty much all custom made, but you know, this one, I made that from using some of the flanges that's available online, and then we got this made, and Mario welded it up for us.
Looks, and then we so put
R35 throttle body, so it's drive-by-wire.
So yeah. Just one R35 throttle body.
So it's drive-by-wire, controlled by Motec.
This has a Motec system.
Yeah, so we got coil, no more distributor. So we use, cranking sensor there, and then we have, coils, coil and plug set up. And, it's a Motec, what was it,
M600? Talk about an overkill for a street car, huh?
But, just to do it right, and, kind of like the our usual resto mod type of theme, and since it's going to be like one of the Kaidohouse demo car, when it's kind of put together something that's more complete for him.
This valve cover is so neat too. Look at that, Kaidohouse plus GReddy. Really, really cool. Amazing. So, and then it's running KWs too. I don't know how many 510s have KW suspension. I can't imagine that many, especially ones that are this slant.
I don't know if this is custom made for him or how he had that set up, but
It's a, what is that, electric water pump setup?
Yes.
And is that because there's just no space?
Yeah,
because normally it shoots out.
Yes, and have a big fan.
Yeah,
and then
yeah.
The clutch fan, and then the the water pump and everything right there.
Yeah.
And we just didn't have enough room, so we machined a block off plate, and then running a water pump because we just don't have enough room.
And is this enough to cool this down for it to make this much power?
It seems to be. I mean, this is like a EK9 radiator that Koyo set us up with, but it seems to be running pretty cool.
So then, what do you have you dynoed this on your dyno?
This was dynoed. It's been about 2 years. I think got it up to about 450, but up top, it was starting to fall off on this setup, so we were going to try to set something up where we could at least get like 600, and then but have like different dial to for him to play with, just to show that it's a fully built motor. So I want to show like the big numbers, but at the same time, drivable for such a car. I think 300 is like more than enough.
Yeah, it's already.
Yeah.
That is so much because the original motor, NA, only makes 150 horsepower.
Yeah.
So, and that's at the crank. So you're saying 450 at the wheel.
Yeah. And with these type of tires and the camber that he's running, he's never going to put it down. But I think for the numbers and what we have put together under the hood, I want to show some of that number first and then have, dial for him to kind of play with. So, It'll be fun, I think.
So do you know what transmission?
This is a 240.
Okay, so like a S13 transmission.
Yeah, S14.
S14.
Yeah.
Five speed.
Yeah, with the five speed with OS Geiken twin plate clutch. We just need to put a LSD in there. I think we'll call up our friends over at OS to make sure we get the LSD back there.
Got it.
So, but yeah, everything else, it's pretty straightforward. Get that, the old school Kyusha House type look, oil cooler in the front.
But what's crazy to me is that this is functional.
Yeah.
Oil is actually running through it.
Yes.
And it's helping cool down the whole system.
It's not functional as far as like, you know, impact.
Right. Yeah, that's...
It's going to be like a...
Oil slicks.
Yeah. Oil slick. And, yeah, so don't hit nobody.
No, no.
Yeah.
What a cool build. Thanks for showing us this.
Yeah.
Love seeing everything that you guys do all the time.
We try to have fun out here.
Cool. Awesome.
Thank you.